Good morning students. In our previous class, we learned about the rational expression and operations on rational expression. Today we are going to learn about the square root of the polynomials. So listen, square root of a given expression p of x is another expression q of x which multiplied by itself gives p of x. So that is in the form q of x into q of x, which is equal to p of x. Read 1 minute. Square root of a given expression p of x is another expression q of x which multiplied by itself. Q of x which multiplied by itself gives the value p of x. For example, listen, this root 14 into root 14, which can be written as 14. That means root of 14 into 14 again can be written as root 14 square. The square and square root get cancelled, get the value of 14. So root 14 into root 14, q of x into q of x, you get the value p of x. That is root 14 into root 14, which is equal to 14. So this can be written as, after taking the value of square root, you can put modulus. Can put modulus. Modulus q of x, which is equal to square root of p of x. Okay. Then q of x is absolute value of q of x. That modulus q of x is the absolute value of q of x. You have to put modulus here. Modulus q of x is absolute value of q of x. Then listen, we can solve this square root by two method. One is factorization, another one is division method. Listen to the exercise number 3.7. Our first problem, first division, how to find the square root for the given function. So listen, so first you listen to the question. 7x squared plus 2 into root 14x plus 2 divided by x squared minus 1 by 2x plus 1 by 16. So listen carefully, take the denominator. Listen to the exercise number 3.7. First problem, how to find the square root for the given polynomial. So first one, second subdivision. Read the question. 7x squared plus 2 into root 14x plus 2 divided by x squared minus 1 by 2x plus 1 by 16. So first of all, take the numerator. What is our numerator? 7x squared plus 2 root 14x plus 2. So listen, so this is the form of square root. So you can change these two terms as in the form of square root. So this 7 can be rewritten as, 7 can be rewritten as same it is, root 7 into root 7 x squared. Then this can be rewritten as, this root 14 can be rewritten as root of 7 into 2. You can split the root and write 2 into root 7 root 2 x. This 2 can be rewritten as root 2 into root 2. Now listen. So this is in the form of, or in the form of root. Root 7 x squared. This can be rewritten as. Then 2 root 14 can be rewritten as 2 into root 7 root 2 x. Plus this 2 will be written as root 2 into root 2. Next. If you multiply this x squared coefficient with the constant term, what is that? Root 7, root 2, root 2. That is nothing but root 14. If you add any two numbers, you will get the value 2 times of root 7 into root 2. So which can be split and write as root 7, root 2, root 7, root 2. So listen carefully. This both get multiples and get 14. So we can write it as in the form of root 14 into root 14. 14 can be rewritten as root 14 into root 14. This root 14 can again we return as root 7 into root 2 and another root 14 is root 7 into root 2. So then center the coefficient of x squared is 2 root 14, thus can be rewritten as 2 times of root 7 into root 2. So if you add any two numbers, you will get 2 root 7 root 2. If you multiply this number, you will get this root 7 root 2 root 2. So listen, what are that number? Root 7 root 2, root 7 root 2. So here 1, if you add, you get 2 times of root 7 root 2. If you multiply root 7 into root 7, root 2 into root 2. Next, apply this here. This first term can be written as it is. Root 7 x squared plus. This can be rewritten as root 7 root 2 x plus root 7 root 2 x plus this constant term remains as it is. Root 2 into root 2. Next lesson, take this root 7 as well as x as common. So what are the remaining term? Root 7 x plus root 2. Listen carefully. Root 7 x, if you take from these two term, root 7 x from these two term, what are the remaining? Root 7 x plus root 2 plus, here you can take root 2 as common from these two term, root 2 as common, what are the remaining term? Root 7 x plus root 2. Then listen, these two will be same, so you can take as one time root 7 x plus root 2. This will be taken as one time and another is root 7 x plus root 2. So both have the basis same. You can add the powers. That can be written as root 7 x plus root 2, 1 plus 1 is 2, that is square. Now look at the denominator. This is our denominator, x square minus 1 by 2 x plus 1 by 16. X square minus 1 by 4 x minus 1 by 4 x plus 1 by 16. That means if you multiply, here the coefficient is 1, 1 into root 16. If you multiply any number, you will get 1 by 16. If you add a subtracting number, you will get the value as minus 1 by 2. So minus 1 by 2, you can multiply minus 1 by 4 and minus 1 by 4. Minus into minus plus, 1 into 1, 1, 4 fours are 16. This is okay. Look at here. So if you write minus 1 by 4 minus 1 by 4. So take 4 as common, our value is minus 1 minus 1. So 4, you can add and put the negative sign. So what is the value? Minus 2 by 4. Now you can cancel this. So what is the remaining value? Minus 1 by 2. Now to get this value, minus 1 by 2 also. So how you can split this? Minus 1 by 2 as minus 1 by 4 minus 1 by 4. Look at this step. X squared can be written as it is. X squared minus this 1 by 2 can be rewritten as 1 by 4x minus 1 by 4x. X squared minus 1 by 4 of x minus 1 by 4 of x. This one constant term 1 by 16 as it is. Then look. Here also x and here also x. From these term you can take x as common. What is the remaining term? X minus 1 by 4. Here you can take x minus as 1 by 4 as common, means what are the remaining term? You can take this negative term. This can be written as negative into negative as positive. For this you can take 1 by 4. This 16 can be written as minus 1 by 4 and minus 1 by 4. So if you take minus 1 by 4 outside, means what are the remaining term from this 1 by 16? Minus 1 by 4. So x minus 1 by 4. So here also x minus 1 by 4 and here also x minus 1 by 4. You can take this term common, x minus 1 by 4 as common. Another term is x minus 1 by 4. So these also bases are same. You can add the powers. So x minus 1 by 4 into x minus 1 by 4 can be rewritten as x minus 1 by 4 whole square. Our question is to find the square root. So that you can take square root of 7x squared plus 2 times of root 14x plus 2 whole divided by x squared minus 1 by 2x plus 1 by 16, which is equal to, we have find out the factor for this, that is root 7x plus root 2 the whole square. So square root of root 7x plus root 2 whole square divided by, for these terms, find out x minus 1 by by the x minus 1 by 4 whole square. Now split and write the square term and square value. So square root of root 7 x plus root 2 whole square divided by square root of x minus 1 by 4 whole square. Now it is done here. Now you can cancel the square and square root. Then you can cross multiple here. 4x minus 1 divided by 4 the whole square. Now this square and square root, this square and square root get cancelled. So here you know one thing. If you want to change the square, you put modulus. So applying the condition, changing square root, you have to put modulus. So modulus of the numerator is root 7 x plus root 2 divided by 4x minus 1 whole divided by 4. So 4 can be taken outside from the modulus. What are the remaining term? Root 7 x plus root 2 divided by 4x minus 1. So this is the first problem we have completed. You have to solve the first subdivision also as homework. Second problem, find the square root of 9x square minus 24xy plus 30xz minus 40yz plus 25z square plus 16y square. So listen, so you must arrange and write in the form of x square, y square, z square. So first term is 9x square, then y square term is plus 16y square plus 25z square. Then arrange as xy, yz, zx. Then what is the xy? Here xy is minus 24xy. Then yz is minus 40yz plus 30xz. Then rearrange. The 9 can be rewritten as 3 square x square. So 3x the whole square. 16y square can be rewritten as 16 as 4 square y square. So 4y whole square. Then 25z square can be rewritten as 5 square z square. 5z the whole square. Then you can use one formula. What does that mean? A plus b plus c whole square, which is equal to a square plus b square plus c square plus 2 times of ab plus 2 times of bc plus 2 times of ca. So you can split and write like that. So a square, b square, c square, here x square, y square, z square. What are the other terms? 2 times of ab. Here our a is 3x, b is 4y. So 2 times of 3x into 4y. Here negative. So negative comes in which terms? Here and here. So both contain the similar term as y. So for y you can take negative. So all equations will be correct. So take y as negative. So 2 times of a is 3x, b is minus 4y plus here also 2 times of y is only the negative term. So minus 4y into 5z plus 2 times of this can be written as 3x into 5x. So listen here. So here you can apply the value as a plus b plus c the whole square. So instead of this b only the negative value minus 4y. So a is 3x, b is minus 4y plus 5 is the whole square. So in this question you have to find the square root only. So apply that square root. Square root of 9x square minus 24xy plus 30xz minus 40yz plus 24z square plus 16y square, which is equal to square root of, so you are solving and get value as 3x minus 4y plus 5z the whole square. Here the square root and square get cancelled. When you are cancelling the square root, you have to put into the modulus sign. So modulus of 3x minus 4y plus 5z. So what is your answer for the square root value? Square root of 9x square minus 24xy plus 30xz minus 40yz plus 25z square plus 16y square, which is equal to modulus of 3x minus 4y plus 5z. Then listen to the second problem, fourth subdivision. 2x square plus 17 by 6x plus 1 and multiple into 3 by 2x square plus 4x plus 2 into 4 by 3x square plus 11 by 3x plus 2. So this is in the form of, here I have written square root of 2 2x squared plus 17 by 6x plus 1 into 3 by 2x squared plus 4x plus 2 into 4 by 3x squared plus 7 by 3x plus 2. So you have to find each and every term. So first, taking the first term, 2x squared plus 17 by 6 into x plus 1. So here you have to take LCM. So LCM is 6. So you have to multiply and divide the both term into 6. So numerator as well as denominator into 6. 2 into 6 is 12. 12 by 6. 12x squared plus, already here 6. So you can write this 17x. Here you have to multiply and divide it with 6. So 1 into 6 is 6. Denominator also 6. You can take denominator 6 as common. Numerator is 12x squared plus 17x plus 6. Then you can take that term numerator. So when you multiply, the coefficient of x squared into the constant term is what? 12 into 6 is 72. So when you get 72, 9 8s are 72. If you add these two numbers, you will get the value as 17. So adding, you get the value 17. Multiplying, you get the value 72. So this can be split and write as, the 17x can be split and write as 9x plus 8x. So listen, 12x squared plus 9x plus 8x plus 6. So from these two terms, you can take 3x as common. You can write this 12 as 3 into 4, this 9 as 3 into 3. So both term contains 3 and x. Okay, take 3x as common. Remaining terms are 4x plus 3. So from these two terms, you can take 4 into 2, 3 into 2. So you can take 2 as common. Remaining term are 4x plus 3. So both contains 4x plus 3. So you can write 4x plus 3 as a single term. So what is the other? 3x plus 2 is the other term. So finding factor for 12x squared plus 17x plus 6, which is equal to 3x plus 2 into 4x plus 3 whole divided by 6. Now find out the second term. What is the second term? 3 by 2x squared plus 4x plus 2. Now you take 2 as common. If you take 2 as common, what are the remaining term? 3x squared, 4 into 2 is 8x, 2 2's are 4, whole divided by 2. Now take the numerator. What is our numerator? 3x squared plus 8x plus 4. If you multiply that term, you will get the value as 12. And if you add the term, you will get the value as 8. So 6 2's are 12. If you add, you get the value as 8. So this 8 can be split and write as 6 2. So 3x squared plus 6x plus 2x, our constant term, plus 4. From these two terms, you can take 3x as common. What are the remaining terms? X plus 2. Next, you can take 2 as common from these terms. What are the other terms? X plus 2. So x plus 2, x plus 2 can be written as a single term. What are the remaining terms? 3x plus 2. So factor for 3x squared plus 8x plus 4, which is equal to 3x plus 2 into x plus 2, 4 divided by 2. Now you have to find the third term. What is the third term? 4 by 3x squared plus 7 by 3x plus 2. So here both term contains the 3. This constant term doesn't contain 3. So I have to take LCM for that. So this can be rewritten as 4x squared plus 11x, 3 into 2 is 6, 4 divided by 3. Now you have to find the factor for the value 4x squared plus 11x plus 6. If you multiply, you get the value as 24, and if you add any two numbers, you will get the value as 11. So what are the numbers? 8 and 3. 8 3's are 24 and 8 plus 3 is 11. 4x squared, this 11x can be written as 8x plus 3x, constant term plus 6. From these two terms, you can take 4x as common, remaining terms are x plus 2. Other two terms you can take plus 3 as common, the remaining is x plus 2. So x plus 2 you can write as one term. What are the remaining value? 4x plus 3. So factor for 4x squared plus 11x plus 6 whole divided by 3, which is equal to x plus 2 into 4x plus 3 whole divided by 3. So now have find out factor for each and every term, you have to apply in the square root value. So listen to the question. Square root of 2x squared plus 17 by 6 x plus 1 into 3 by 2 x squared plus 4x plus 2 into 4 by 3 x squared plus 11 by 3 x plus 2. So you can apply the factors value. So what is the factor for this? 3x plus 2 into 4x plus 3 whole by 6 into what is the second term? 3x plus 2 into x plus 2 whole divided by 2. Our third term is x plus 2 into 4x plus 3 whole divided by 3. So look at the terms. Here 3x plus 2, here also 3x plus 2. So you can write 3x plus 2 the whole square. 4x plus 3, here also 4x plus 3, you can write 4x plus 3 whole square because all are in multiplication only. Then x plus 2 into x plus 2 is x plus 2 the whole square. So listen to the denominator 6, 2, 3. So this can be taken as 6. You multiply these two terms, again you get 6. So 6 into 6 can be rewritten as 6 squared. So I have taken out 1 by 6 square into 3x plus 2 the whole square, 4x plus 3 the whole square plus x plus 2 the whole square. Now take square root for separately the numerator and denominator. So split and write for each and every term. Root of 3x plus 2 the whole square, root of 4x plus 3 the whole square, root of x plus 2 the whole square. The square root and square get cancelled for each and every term. In denominator also root of 6 squared. So that root and root square root and get cancelled. So you can take this 1 divided by 6 from out of the modulus, because modulus doesn't contain the numerical term, it contains the variable term only. So you can take 1 by 6 outside. What are the remaining term? Modulus of 3x plus 2 into 4x plus 3 into x plus 2. While you taking the square root, at last you have to put the modulus sign. This is the square root problem. Go through once. Exercise number 3.8. In a previous exercise 3.7, we have find out the square root value using the factorization method. Now we are doing it with the long division method. Finding the square root of the polynomial by long division method. So you already know, well known for the numbers, square root using the long division, well known about the numbers. Here we are doing for this algebraic expression. Given question is 4x power 4 minus 28x cube plus 37x squared plus 42x plus 9. So this is our question. You have to find the square root using the long division method. For long division method, you have to put division like this. So listen carefully. For the first step, you have to split and write this term. So first is what? 2x squared into 2x squared is 4x power 4. 2x squared into 2x squared is only 4x power 4. That is the squared value. Next you can multiply this divisor into 2. So 2 into 2x squared is 4x squared. So when this 4x squared changes into minus 28x cubed. So if you multiply this 4 into minus 7 only, you get this negative value minus 28. Already here x squared, you have to multiply with the x only, you can get the x cubed. So if you put that 7x here also, you have to put that in divisor also. So 4x squared minus 7x into minus 7x. So 4x squared into minus 7x. 4 into minus 7 is minus 28. This x squared term into x term is x cubed. Now you multiply the second term. Minus 7 into minus 7 is plus 49. X into x is x squared. Now sign change. These two terms get cancelled. These are various terms you have to subtract. So 49 minus 37 is 12. Negative is the biggest value, so you have to put that negative sign. So in this step you have to listen carefully. You have to write the first term as it is, second term into 2. Second term is what? Minus 7x into 2 is minus 14x. So here you want to put other two terms. So for that you have to listen to the first term. Here the first term is 4x square. Here the first term is 12x square. So 4 into which term is 12? 4 into 3 is 12. Already x squared is there. So you have to put the negative sign minus 3. So minus 3 as well as minus 3. So 4x squared into minus 3 is minus 12x squared. Then you can take this term. Other two terms also. So for this step you can consider the first one. For the second term you can consider two terms because you are keeping two terms here. Then you have the remainder as one term. Again you can take the two terms because here you can take three terms. So 4x squared into minus 3 is 12x squared. Then is minus 14x into 3. So minus into minus is plus. 14 3s are 42x. Minus into minus is plus 9. So sign changing. All the terms get cancelled, you will get the remainder as 0. So listen once again carefully. Finding the square root of the polynomial using the long division method. Our question is 4x power 4 minus 28x cubed plus 37x squared plus 42x plus 9. So you have to split and write this first term. So 4 can be split and written as 2 into 2. So 2 2's are 4. This x power 4 can be written as x squared into x squared. X squared into x squared, x power 4. 4 x power 4. After sign changing, both terms get cancelled. Now you have to multiply this divisor into 2. So 2 into 2 power 4 is 4 x squared. So when you take another two terms for this calculation, so when this 4 gets into minus 28, if you multiply 4 with 7 only, you get 28. If you put minus 7, you get minus 28. Here x squared is there, x cube is here. So you have to multiply with x. That value is minus 7x. So you have to put minus 7x here also in quotient also. So 4x squared minus 7x, here also minus 7x. For these steps, you should not consider the first term. You take this divisor and multiply with this term only. So 4x squared into minus 7x. 4 into 7 is minus 28. X squared into x is x cubed. Then next term you have to put 7 into 7 is 49. Minus into minus is plus. Then x into x is x squared. Now sign changing and get cancel the first term only. Second term is minus 12 x squared. You can take other two terms. 42x plus 9. Now listen, for first term you are multiplying with 2. For the second one, leave this first term, write as it is. Second term will be gets multiplied into 2. So second term is 7 into 2 is 40x. So listen to the term. Here our first term is 12x squared. Here only 4. So 4 into which is minus 12. 4 into minus 3 is only minus 12. So you have to put minus 3 here also and here also. So 4 x squared into minus 3 is minus 12 x squared. Then minus 14x into minus 3 is plus 42x. Minus 3 into minus 3 is plus 9. After sign changing, this term gets as a remainder 0. So listen, if it is not 0, you can proceed the step as it is. So square root of 4 x power 4 minus 28 x cube plus 37 x squared plus 42 x plus 9, which is equal to, you are taking square root, you have to put modulus sign. So what is your answer is, your question is only your answer. Your question is only your answer. This is reminder. So what is your question? Modulus of 2 x squared minus 7 x minus 3. So move on to the next problem. Next problem, finding the value of a and b, the given polynomials. The given polynomials are perfect square. Perfect square means it contains the remainder 0. You are finding the remainder 0. The question is your answer for finding the square root value. Here they already given you. This question is a perfect square. Using the perfect square, you have to find the value of a and b. So listen to the question. 100 plus 220x plus 361x squared plus bx power 3 plus ax power 4. I have rearranged and written the question. Next, 100. When it is comes 100, our 10 squared is 100. So you can write 10 into 10. 100 can be written as 10 into 10. So 10 tens are 100. Sign changing, these two numbers get cancelled. So take other two terms. What are the terms? 220x plus 361x squared. So before step you have multiple into 2. As same it is, you have to multiple here also into 2. So 10 twos are 20. So check with the term. Here the value is 220. So 20 into how much is 220? 20 into 11 is 220. Here you need 1x value. So you have to put 11x. 20 into 11x is nothing but 220x. So you have to put plus 11x in divisor also as well as in quotient also. So listen here, 20 into, you can leave this chain, multiple these terms. 20 into 11x is 220x plus 11 into 11 is 121, x into x is x squared. Now sign change. These two terms get cancelled. So remaining value, 361 minus 121. 361 minus 121, 11 get cancelled. 6 minus 2 is 4, 3 minus 1 is 2. So answer is 240x squared. Now you can take other two terms also. So what are the two terms? 240x squared plus bx cube plus ax power 4. For the next term, you have to multiple the second term into 2. First term can be rewritten as it is. First term can be rewritten as it is. Second term into 2. Next, what you need? Here your value is 240x squared. So multiple 20 into 12 only, you get the value what? 240. 20 into 12 is 240 and you need 1x squared. So you have to multiple 12x squared, both quotient and divisor. So 20 plus 22x plus 12x squared. 20 into, you can leave this term, multiple this term only. This term will be multiplied with the 12x squared. 20 into 12x squared is 240x squared plus 22x into 12x squared is plus 264x cubed plus 12 into 12 is 144x power 4. Now listen, after sign changing, this first term gets cancelled, the remaining value can be written as b minus this number. If you have number, you can subtract easily. Here the value is that, so you have to put like this, b minus 264x cube plus a minus 144x power 4. In the given question itself, the given polynomial is a perfect square. So you can take b minus 264 which is equal to 0, a minus 144 which is equal to 0. So you know what is the value of b, b which is equal to 264, a which is equal to 144. So listen, for second problem, in the question itself they given, the polynomial is a perfect square. You have to find the value for a and b. So take the question, 100 plus 220x plus 361x squared plus bx cube plus ax power 4. So 100 can be rewritten as 10 into 10 is 100. So you can cancel this 100. Next, multiple this 10 into 2, you get 20. So 20 into 11x only 220x. So you have to put 11x in divisor as well as quotient. So 20 into 11 is 220x. 11 elevens are 121x squared. So sign changing, first term get cancelled. You can write this term. After subtracting you get 240x squared. You can take other two terms, bx cube plus ax power 4. Now listen, 20 plus 22x. So when 20 changes into 240, well you multiply with this 12. So 12x squared, here also no x squared. So you have to multiply with x squared. 20 into 12x squared is 240x squared. Then 22 into 12x squared is 264x cubed plus 12x squared into 12x squared is 144x power 4. After subtracting you get the term as it is, b minus 264x cubed plus a minus 144x power 4. The given polynomial is a perfect square. You can take the term which is equal to 0. B minus 264 equal to 0. A minus 64 which is equal to 0. You need only the value of B and A. So A which is equal to 144, B which is equal to 264. Similarly, you can do the third problem. How to find the value of M and N? The given polynomials are perfect square. So listen to the question. Our question is x power 4 minus 8x cube plus m x square plus nx plus 16. So when you get this x power 4, x square into x square is our x power 4. So after sign changing, this first term get cancelled. Now you take the second and third term. What is the second term? Minus 8x cube plus m x square. So here you want to multiply this term into 2. So 2 into x squared is 2x squared. But here 8x cubed, that is negative 8x cubed. So you have to multiply with minus 4x. Both quotient as well as divisor. 2x squared minus 4x. Then consider these two terms. 2x squared minus 4x into minus 4x. 2x squared into minus 4x is minus 8x cubed. Then minus minus is get plus 4 4s are 16, x into x is x squared. Then listen, you have to take this term as it is, this term into 2. So minus 8x. Then listen to here, m minus 16x squared plus nx plus 16. So when this term gets 16, 4 4s are only 16. So you have to put 4 here also in the quotient. So you have to multiply this number that positive 4. 2x squared into 4 is 8x squared. Minus 8x into 4 is minus 32x. 4 4s are 16. Now listen. You have to separate and write. So sign changing. So after sign changing, m minus 16 minus 8, which is m minus 24x squared, then n minus 32, n plus minus is cancelled into plus, n plus 32x which is equal to 0. So the remainder is 0 when the given polynomial is a perfect square. Given polynomial is perfect square, our remainder is 0. So we can take m minus 24 which is equal to 0, n plus 32 which is equal to 0. You need only the value of m and n. M equal to 24 and n equal to minus 32. So listen carefully for the third problem, how to find the value of m and n. Using the given condition, the polynomial is the perfect square. So you have to find out the value. At last, you can write the given polynomial is a perfect square. Since the remainder is 0, you can take m minus 24 which is equal to 0, n plus 32 which is equal to 0, m equal to 24, n equal to minus 32. So listen, in today's topic, we have learned about the square of the given polynomial. So using the two methods, one is factorization method, another one is the long division method. For factorization method, you have to find the factor, afterward take the square root value. After taking square root, you have to put the modulus sign. For long division method, you can use this procedure. Thank you, students.